Champion, and all of us here at EA Sports so proud to bring you Super Bowl 55 from Raymond James Stadium in Tampa, and it's a matchup full of intrigue. Tonight it's all on the line. We play for the Lombardi Trophy as it'll be the AFC champion New England Patriots taking on the NFC champions, the Philadelphia Eagles. Brandon Gaudin alongside my good friend Charles Davis. And Charles, we start by taking a look at the Patriots. You know, they did it again, their 12th Super Bowl appearance ever. That's a record. They were able to rebound from the wild card loss to the Titans last year. And a lot of folks at the time said, that's the end of the Patriots dynasty. Apparently, they were wrong.
Look, they just find a way to get it done each and every year. So anyone who wants to count them out, you're almost always wrong. They're trying to make it four wins in 7 years in the Super Bowl. That rivals the Steelers in the 1970s. But when you think about this Patriots franchise, we're talking about the 2000s, 2010s, and now we're in the...
And he can't field it cleanly. It's loose. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get this up to the 29. Out now come the Patriots as they are led out by their quarterback, a former MVP of the National Football League back in 2015, Cam Newton.
And when he's at the top of his game, you see that big smile? That's when you know everything is clicking. That means he's accurate throwing the football. They can't get him down in the run game. And his team is having a whole lot of fun, because when they score a touchdown, some fan's going to get lucky and get the game ball.
A throw left side to start the drive is complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 14 yards there on the first play from scrimmage.
First and 10 at the 42-yard line.
On first and 10, Newton on the move to his left. The improv on the scramble there gets him six, and it'll be second down.
You know, I don't think this is the last time we'll see that in this game. This guy has mobility, and they want to use his legs in the game plan. So there'll be designed runs as well as his scrambles.
And a second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. Call that a loss of a yard, and things get a little more difficult here, third and five. From the gun on third down, Newton. Eagle pressure, too much this time. Down he goes. Brandon Graham with a big-time sack on third down. It's a loss of seven. And we say it all the time, have to be able to get rid of the ball sooner than that.
You have to help your offensive line out. They're going to protect you as best they can. And if you're getting 3 to 5 seconds to throw the ball, they're doing a really nice job. But when you hold it and give up a sack, you're really almost discrediting their work.
So now here comes the Eagles offense as they get ready to take over. They'll be led out by a guy who beat these Patriots in Super Bowl 52, and we remember that like it was just yesterday. It's Nick Foles. And they'll come out with a three tight end look on the first play of the drive. On play action, they'll throw. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. He was a 1,000-yard receiver during the regular season, and that's his first catch of the Super Bowl, and he picks up the first down. Alshon Jeffrey, so dangerous even when a defender's near him.
He's got such a big body, a ability to run, positions himself well, excellent control. And you're exactly right. Even if people are draped on him, he often comes up with the catch. He really symbolizes what people are looking for in receivers in today's NFL.
Once more, he was looking for Alshon Jeffrey, and now it's second down. Now a nice throw here right side. He hauls it in. And he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Patriots 37. A good pickup there, 22.
Number 37 yards.
Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And this will go as a gain of 7 as he gets it to the 30-yard line.
It's a gain of 7. Brings up 2nd and 3.
Looking to throw again on 2nd down. Foles. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's 3rd down. With a heavy set out there. 3 tight ends in the formation for 3rd and 3. Gonna look deep for Jeffrey. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up 4th down. And this may be a big early turning point in this Super Bowl. They're gonna go for it on 4th down here. Bringing it in, Jackson left side. And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down. How about them biting off 15 yards there on the 4th down attempt and keeping the drive alive? 3 tight ends in the ballgame here on 1st and 10. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. And he'll take this into the end zone. Now hold on here, we do have a flag down. So let's see what this is about. Tag came before the ball got there, and the flag is thrown.
Timing is everything, isn't it? And it's so hard to cover these great receivers. They have such great body.
And that's going to be caught for an Eagles touchdown. With the first touchdown of this Super Bowl, and the Eagles have taken the early lead. One of the keys to their long winning streak has been scoring first. An ideal drive right there, getting the first 6 points of the ball game.
Do you go back to our meeting with the offensive coordinator?
Oh, yeah.
What he told us?
Absolutely.
With some teams, I script to probe in the early part of the game. Other teams, I script to attack. They've been in attack mode for these ball games and continue that in this one.
Elliott good with a PAT, and it's now a 7-0 game. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. And a short kick taken about the 16. Well, a dangerous return man showing it here.
Patriots take over 1st and 10 at their own 34-yard line.
The Pats at the line ready to go. They trail early on in this Super Bowl as they come up 1st and 10. They fake the give. Newton. Now he's flushed out left. He'll run it. And he goes out of bounds just shy of the 45. Nothing open downfield. He keeps it himself for 11 and a 1st down. So an instance there of Cam being Cam. We know he can use his legs.
And with that big body, it's hard to get him down, even if you get a clear shot on him. Plus, he moves it a lot faster than what people think. And boy, does he have fun playing the game of football.
3 yards the gain there, 2nd down.
Brings up 2nd and 7 at the 47-yard line.
Now a carry for White. He'll be taken down at the 48 for a pickup of 2 yards.
He was brought down by Javon Hargrave. A 2-yard pickup brings up 3rd and 6. That's the end of the first quarter with the score Eagles 7, Patriots nothing.
Throwing on 3rd down, Newton. He hits White, complete. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35.
Patriots.
It'll be a Patriot 1st down on a pickup of 16.
36-yard line.
They'll run with White. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down.
The ball carrier.
The Pro Bowler Fletcher Cox there to get him down.
No gain on the play. Brings up 2nd.
Throwing on 2nd down. Newton. Cam fighting. He lost the football. It's out. And the Eagles have recovered. Look at the big man rumble. Past the 20.
Days of just getting a fumble recovery. Everyone's into taking it the other way, trying to create points themselves, aren't they?
Well, they are, and now a terrific opportunity inside the. This is taken in by Jeffrey. He's got it. Touchdown, Eagles. Alshon Jeffrey, his second touchdown of the Super Bowl. And the Eagles able to push further out in front.
A lot of people might call this backyard football. Sometimes just understanding who you've got out wide and who you're going to throw it to. Give him an opportunity to go up and make a play, even when contested. Looks like that one worked out pretty well. The trust factor, in effect.
Jake Elliott to kick off for Bill.
Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. This is taken just shy of the 10. But a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line.
At their own 30-yard line.
The Pats at the line ready to go. And they had the fumble last time that led to a touchdown. That's a no-no. We'll see what they do here this go-around.
A big no-no. Put that in capital letters. Turning it over, the other team takes it down and scores. That can be a deflator for a football team. Now it's up to the offense to get back out on the field and pick things up.
Yeah, they're out there. We'll see if they can pick those things back up. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
For a lot of guys playing this game, there's no better feeling than running right through a tackle. He's able to lower center of gravity and churn his legs for a really nice pickup.
First down, here's White. And he'll take this one up close to about the 45. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
2 yards on the pickup. It's second and 8.
They'll try the air now with Newton. Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete. James White, the man he was looking for out of the backfield. But now it's third down.
And 8 yards to go.
From the gun, here's Newton. It's caught inside the 25. And all the way in. Touchdown, New England. Julian Edelman, 55 yards. And the Patriots have cut it back within a score. They were already down 2 scores early. They needed something to try to stem that tide, and that certainly qualifies. A big play to get them in the end zone.
It qualifies indeed because, let's face it, they don't get something done on this drive, turn it back over. This game could be 88 and out the gate early.
What? 88 and out the gate?
Yeah.
What's that?
Well, listen, I used to hear my old man talking about it. It usually meant that thing's done.
Well, now that they got the touchdown, it's not 88 and out the gate. We still got a good game going ahead of us. The Eagles just about set to go to work on offense. They've got the lead, and certainly a big reason why some of these catches we take a look at right now.
And I've seen it so many times that when units start to play really well, they feed off of each other and play even better. And they're making every catch possible. Contested, non-contested, easy, difficult.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. 2 drives, 2 touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
An excellent way to start the drive there. 18 yards. First and 10, and they've got 3 tight ends out there. A jumbo package look. Now Foles. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. There's Foles. Jackson's got it over the middle. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Deshaun Jackson, 47 yards. And the Eagles add on to their lead. So simple math here in the first half. They've had three drives offensively, and they have scored every time, and they've got the lead.
Well, whenever we talk about adjustments, we usually talk about an offense making adjustments, right? This is all about the defense. They've got to figure out some way, somehow, to slow them down. Do they blitz a little bit more? Do they play more zone coverage? Right now, they don't know where to go because they're hitting them in every direction.
Elliott good on the extra point, and it's now 21-7.
For Philadelphia.
Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. From the 10. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line.
First and 10 at their own 30-yard line.
The Pats at the line, ready to go. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minutes. Who knows? Let's see what they decide to do.
7 yards to pick up there. 2 minutes remain in this opening half of Super Bowl 55. Coming up in a couple of minutes, we'll get you to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. The coach will have stats and scores from earlier today in the NFL. Now a toss left side into the hands of his tight end. And he'll get up near the 45. They'll spot it at the 44. 7 yards there and a first down.
When you struggle on offense, you're looking for anything possible to get you going. Sometimes you're like basketball teams that don't normally press. You put a press on, bring people to life, make them move a little bit quicker. Maybe that'll help them as they head towards the half.
And he has another first down as they'll get the ball down to the Eagles 35. Now the Patriots going to use one of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Again, Newton. He completes it right side to White. Now the Patriots will use the second of their timeouts, as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. Able to get 7 on that first down pass play. 2nd and 3. To the air again, Newton. That's caught by Hollister. And he's able to get it to the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
10-yard line.
From the red zone now, Newton. And not able to get it that time. He hit on 6 straight passes. Not there. 2nd down.
Brings up 2nd and 10 at the 20-yard line.
Throwing again. Newton. And a quick throw here. That's complete. They do get a yard there, but only a yard. Leaves them with 3rd and 9 looming. Now play number 8 on this drive, and they need 9 yards to pick up the first on 3rd. Pushes past him. Over the middle, Julian Edelman. It's complete. And he lost the football. And it's picked up by the Eagles. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
We have seen this before, and we know coaches preach about this and work on it all the time. Catch the ball. You know there's going to be some traffic somewhere. They've got to put it away and secure it as they try and get downfield.
After reviewing the play,
Bartman in less than 2 minutes ago in the game, which means that this challenge was initiated by the fellas in New York.
And if you're the coach, you're thinking, thank you, New York. And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call. So with 4 seconds to go in the half, here's the field goal unit onto the field. From the left hash, a chip shot here. Rohrwasser's kick is good. And that will do it for this first half. So we are at halftime of this Super Bowl 52 rematch with the Eagles on top at the break. As we send you a stone's throw away across I-4 to Orlando, there standing by is Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach?
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. What a season this has been. Hard to believe it ends tonight. As we'll get back to you guys for the second half of this Super Bowl in just a moment. In the game you're watching, it's the former Super Bowl MVP, Nick Foles, with a strong first half. His three touchdown passes have his guys out in front as we hand things back over to Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. Both teams ready after the halftime spectacle, and we are back underway in Super Bowl 55. Oh, he sheds himself free up to midfield. Look at him go inside the 30. He will take this all the way.
Marquise Goodwin. Touchdown, Eagles.
And talk about taking words and bringing them to life. At halftime, I will guarantee you in their locker room, they talked about pressing the kicking game because you can get an advantage if you do it right, and they just did.
Elliott on for the extra point. And the lead is up to 18 now. So that one officially goes down to the books as a return for a touchdown of the kickoff of 103 yards.
Jake Elliott to kick off for Philadelphia.
So now the other return teams out there, as they'll try to duplicate what they just saw. A short kick taken at the 18. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30.
At their own 32-yard line.
The Pats at the line, ready to go. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. Slant route, caught by Edelman. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. A gain of 13, it's a first down.
At the 48-yard line.
They will run with White out of the shotgun. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down.
Well, they certainly have been able to get him going and establish the run, so I think it's time to abandon that plan and start chucking it all over the park. And you know who's excited about that? The defensive front. They got to just pin their ears back and get after him now.
And he's going to get stopped up quickly. Give him a yard down to the 43.
A gain of a yard brings up third and five.
From the gun on third down, Newton. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
He's had trouble finding open receivers all game, CD, and that's because really there hasn't been many this deep.
And how about this, a fake? Oh, but this is going to backfire as it's intercepted. Picked off at the 22. And he's able to get it back to the 41-yard line. First possession of the third quarter, an interception, so maybe a second-half tone setter.
Indeed, and not the tone they wanted to set. That's the equivalent of running out the wrong door and running into your pool instead of running it.
Alshon Jeffrey, touchdown, Philadelphia. Alshon Jeffrey with his third touchdown of the Super Bowl. And the Eagles had six to their lead.
And this is obviously quite a performance. And most of the time when we talk about someone putting a team on their back, I think we're talking about a guy who runs the football. In this case, it's a guy out wide catching it, and he's done exactly that, truly leading his team right now towards victory.
Three touchdown catches. He's been the headliner.
Jake Elliott to kick off for Philadelphia.
Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. And a short kick taken at about the 16. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape, up past the 30.
First down 10 at their own 31-yard line.
The Pats at the line, ready to go. They are right now just ice cold. I mean, they have struggled big time in this game, and they're getting blown out. How do they adjust?
So tough, because we always talk about it being a team game and you need all 11 working well together. But every now and then, partner, you need that one guy who can make a play against all odds that maybe can ignite things. And I think that's what they're looking for right now.
Yeah, you talk about going to your playmakers. They probably need to do it.
Find someone that you're used to touching the football that makes big plays and give them that opportunity to maybe wake up everyone else.
From the gun on third down. Newton, short pass to the tight end Hollister, and he goes out right around the 39. They stop him for only three that time, and that'll bring up fourth down.
So much about offense is what you call hidden yardage. You know, you throw the ball to someone, they catch it, and then they can make a big play. You know, they create a play, run after catch. They did a really nice job there of limiting that and keeping him from a first down.
Yeah, stopped him in his tracks. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And following that long touchdown pass, a one-play drive last time, see if the defense, you know they're ready. They don't want that to happen again.
And you would have thought they would have been ready the last time. I mean, that's what you work on all the time. Make sure that no one gets behind you. That's the cardinal sin of defense, not giving up the long pass. They did. Let's see how they adjust.
To throw on second and 10. Foles. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down. Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Foles. This is caught by Jackson. A big seam, and he might go all the way. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Deshaun Jackson, his second touchdown of the Super Bowl. And the Eagles continue to roll.
In order to lead in a game, you're going to get plenty of contributors. But that's his second touchdown catch of this game. He's one of the key guys in this one.
And you better believe he'll be looking for the hat trick here as this one continues to go. And the lead grows even larger here in the third quarter. So they only needed three plays on that drive. And it was capped off by an Eagles touchdown.
Jake Elliott to kick off for Philadelphia.
Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. And a short kick taking it about the 16. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line.
30-yard drive.
So the Patriots coming out now. And with this deficit, you can't have too many more drives like the last drive where you had to punt it away.
You know what I would tell my offense right here? The punter doesn't exist, guys. He doesn't even exist. He's not a team anymore. I just cut him, all right? So you've got to go out and create some offense for us here and give us some points. No way does that guy get on the field on this drive.
Poor punter.
Yeah, it wasn't his fault. But hey, listen, there's got to be casualties at times. We're trying to win a game.
The drive starts with a run by White. And they take him down, losing yardage back at the 27. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
This defense is just flat getting after it. They've not given up much of anything in the run game. Case in point right there.
On second and 12, Newton is going to find his running back. It's complete.
Newton's pass.
It's a 4-yard pickup, and it'll be third down.
That's a good job there by the corner. We do talk about this a lot, that a lot of corners see their job as simply covering receivers. Tackling isn't everyone's thing. But in this case, he came up quickly and made a nice, sure tackle.
It'll be a gain of 8, but it also lead to a fourth down.
It's fourth down.
The Patriots send out their punter. On, we think, to punt, though he's faked it earlier, but he was unsuccessful. 44 on his first punt, and this is a good kick as well. With it is Jackson. One quarter remains here in the Super Bowl. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. The Eagles. Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And they are trying to play it cool down on the sidelines, but they know that they are very close now to wrapping this thing.
He's got a man complete. 20, 10, and he'll take it into the end zone for an Eagles touchdown. Alshon Jeffrey with a record fourth Super Bowl touchdown tonight as his guys continue to pour it on.
As that lead just swells and swells. Look, this has been dominance in all three phases, offense, defense, and special teams.
So don't we have to give a lot of credit, not just to what we've seen today, but the preparation in advance, coaching staff, commitment by the players to the game plan, and being ready to go in this one? You're exactly right. Clean sweep. And boy, they're going to celebrate this one after it's over.
And on the other side, this is the game film you just flush and never go back and review.
Jake Elliott to kick off for Philadelphia.
Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. This is taken just shy of the 10. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line.
Over first and 10 at their own 29-yard line.
The Patriot offense now set to come back out onto the field. And their Super Bowl hopes are dwindling here in the fourth. That AFC crown from 2 weeks ago is starting to seem like a distant memory. And this one just has not gone as they had hoped. Newton on first down. And the catch made here by Marquise Lee. Newton, give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here.
In so many ways, throwing the hitch route is actually one of the safer things an offense can do. Get the ball out to the receiver as fast as possible, hope he's got man-to-man coverage, and hope that his athleticism wins on the perimeter.
And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. When in doubt, do it yourself as he keeps it for three and a first down.
First and 10 at the 42-yard line.
To throw is Newton. This is White on the screen. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. That goes as a gain of 11 and a Patriot first down.
They ran that one well. And not only did they pick up a nice chunk of yardage on the screen, they sent a message to the defense. Rush the passer all you want, but you better be careful. We can hit you going back the other direction.
Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
Second and 10, Newton again. He'll buy some time right, and he'll get it down here to the 43. He'll wind up getting four there on his own, but it will leave him now with a third down situation.
Third and 6.
Out of the gun, Newton. And he finds a man on the crossing route.
That's up.
And he will have a Patriots first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. A shotgun snap for Newton. Sunu with a grab over the middle. And down inside the 15 he goes. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well.
First down. First and 10 at the 14-yard line.
They'll run on first down. White. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
There's no question that coming into this game, this defense is pretty vocal about his desire to take this running back out of his game. And all that pregame whooping has turned into results.
And this is incomplete.
It certainly didn't appear that that's where he wanted to go with the ball initially, so he tried to get something out of it by dumping it off to his running back unsuccessfully.
They'll roll it. Cam fighting. He lost the football. It's out.
Brandon Graham.
Second time in this game, Charles, the ball has squirted out from his hands. Luckily, his teammate was there to pounce on it.
You're right. Got the lucky bounce, able to retain possession. You know, we often talk about the combine and why do we measure quarterbacks' hands. Is that really a big deal? It's for situations like this. Do you have the hands big enough and strong enough to hold onto the football while being jostled?
Rohrwasser's kick is good. And they'll get back three, but this remains a large deficit. So the field goal there caps what winds up to be an 11-play drive.
Well, partner, that's a lot of offense to run there to only get 3 points. So I just wonder, are they going to recycle those plays because they were successful in getting three? Or do you go to another section of the playbook trying to find one to get you into the end zone and get you six?
At their own 37-yard line.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And a few kneel downs should just about do it. Now, defensively, they do have all three timeouts, but very little reason to use them at this point. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 15 yards is the pick up there, and the drive starting very nicely. First down. Another example of this offense really having their way, Charles, and another big chunk play there on the ground.
And when you look at the defense, they've got to do a much better job of wrapping up when they tackle. A lot of great opportunities continue to slip through their fingers, as do the runners.
3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Brings up second and seven.
Now it looks like he'll throw here. Jeffrey with a catch left side. And he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly.
Well, there's just about a minute left in this game, and they're still taking it to the end zone. And you know they could have taken a knee there, but they decided to play this one all the way out. And I think their philosophy is, we're going to give you everything we've got. If we just go ahead and take a knee now, we're actually showing you disrespect that way, like taking pity on you. They're not about to do that to their opponent.
Elliott now to add the extra point. Now this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead. The drive there only spanning 3 plays. The result, Philadelphia in the end zone.
Jake Elliott to kick off for Philadelphia.
Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. From the 10. And they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27.
The Patriots take over first and 10 at their own 27-yard line.
The Pats at the line, ready to go. Let's just be frank. They're playing for pride at this point.
That's all that's left, because victory, not a chance now. And I can't wait to see how they actually go about doing it, because there are a lot of people watching the body language of the guys on the field now, and if they call plays they want executed, they need to do that and do it really well. Otherwise, there could be repercussions.
We'll see how they handle the waning moments of this one. Marquise Lee, the intended target, and it's third and short.
3 yards to go.
Newton now to throw. He's got Sanu. And he'll get this inside of Philly's 20 before being taken down. A big play there for the Patriots. 51 yards. This will be caught just inside the 10. And down inside the 10 here before he's out of bounds right around the 7. And the Lombardi Trophy will rest in the city of brotherly love. The Philadelphia Eagles are the Super Bowl champs. For the victors, getting to hoist that Lombardi Trophy. You know, we've talked to guys that have done it, and they say there's no better feeling in sports.
I don't know how there can be. The journey to get to this game is incredible. And then to finally break through and win it when all eyes are on this game alone because there's nothing else going on, that's just got to be absolutely amazing. That, the task, incredible. But the accomplishment, forever.
And they are the Super Bowl champs. The Lombardi Trophy is theirs, and so are bragging rights for an entire season. What a season it has been. Feels like we have been there every step of the way. Our entire crew doing a wonderful job. Thanks to my broadcast partner, Charles Davis. For all those guys, I'm Brandon Gunn signing off. We'll talk to you next season right here on EA Sports.
Player has a zone ability. This is a powerful ability that can be active.
What's heart to a guy with cash? What's pain to a guy that's mad? Said, What spoke to a guy with a mask? What spoke to a guy with a plan? I just wanna kick it, that's all I ask. Like, let me explain what I did. Can I kick it? Hold on. Yeah, I got some rings and a range. Can I kick it? Yeah. Don't ask me a thing. How I got her, how I did it. Yeah. Spent the whole half, had a blast. Can I kick it? Even with a sprain, pain. Can I kick it? Did the flex, I went and bought a chain. Can I kick it? Things ain't been the same. Things have changed. Can I kick it? People acting different, so I ask, can I?
This is the last opportunity to re-sign your players or they'll become free agents.
But I know I got an antidote to retain some kind of self-control. Look inside my head through a telescope. You erase all the calls from a telephone. No sense of smile, maybe tell a joke. Holding back your tears, singing minimal syllables. Yeah, look at me, the asylum. Was a fate or mistake, cause the time ain't up. Yet the parts of my mind don't get much love. If you want to my head, come and call me up. You look like a twisted Robin Hood. Yeah, you take from the rich and the poor and us. Wearing diamond shoes where you walk your pugs. In a time you create where there ain't no love.
Stats such as the 40-yard dash are now available in scouting.
These are the players that are in.
Yeah, I use a dub. I'm a win. I won't lose with this. I'ma act a fool with this. I'ma act a fool with this. I'm turning knob, can't resist, I'm incredible. Yeah, came for the dollars, call it vegetable. Can I get the dash, can I catch me rope? Ooh, can I get the dash, can I catch me rope? Your whole team is no competition. Boy, I did it by myself, it's a solo mission. Running up the charts, I'm a fool, dog. Turn the whole field to a schoolyard. Bunch of students ain't eating round here. I'm the GOAT, little man, and I made it loud and clear.
been ready for this. Since like 9-5, I've been eager for this. Talent on the rise, I'm consistent with this. Trophy is the prize, ain't no gimmicks with this. Okay, now what's left on them? Told you I'ma flex on them. I did it all subtle, ooh, and then I hit that exit on them. Gotta blame my faith, cause these odds ain't got nothing on them. I secured it safe, for the credo, I ain't dropping nothing, ooh. Only winning is exception, ain't no truce. Ain't no dub, ain't no L on my crew. Only winning is exception on my crew. Ain't no dub, ain't no L.
I use a dub, I'ma win, I won't lose with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Yeah, I'ma act a fool with this.
Okay,
stylish masterpiece, body, body. Stylish masterpiece, body, body.
Party going up.